Well, first of all, I just want to thank God for giving me the wisdom and the patience, being the man that I am. And also, I'd like to thank Stan Wilcox, President Thresher, for giving me the opportunity. And also, I would like to thank this football team, these players, for doing what they did. Stand behind not just me, the coaches that coached in this bowl game. Because that says a lot about Florida State University football. We have character here. No matter what people say, we're not going anywhere. We're not going anywhere. And so those are my words to these kids. I just want to say thank you guys, and I love you from the heart. It's not about me as being the interim head coach. It's about y'all making the experience great for you all. That's what it's about. That's what it's supposed to be out in college football. Not about us as grown men. It's about these young men growing, developing as men. So one day, they can be great husbands and great fathers. That's what it's about.
Yes, sir. All
right, questions?
Coach Hagan, it's got to be really a wonderful experience through 7-6 and to never have had now you another winning season, if you will, and you've been to the Walk-Ons Independence Bowl. What did that mean, winning the trophy?
Been a lot for the kids at Florida State University. And just think back, this bowl record that we have, we're gonna keep moving forward. We, not me. In the winning season, we're gonna keep moving forward. Because that's who we are, Florida State University. We wasn't built on a sandy foundation. We was built on a solid foundation here. So we're not going anywhere as a family.
Coach, 4 touchdowns from James Blackman today, Independence Bowl record. You just talked about his progression as a freshman throughout the season culminating today.
His progression, he had to grow very fast. He had to take the diapers off and go to work. But just joking with James, you know, I love him. But think about it. James, being an 18-year-old kid, coming in Florida State, starting for, what, 12 games? That's a lot of pressure. But these players, they put their arms around him. Even though James made a few mistakes, they picked him back up. That says a lot about his character. He's a fighter. He's a noble.
Hey, Cam, breaking the FSU single season freshman record, Danny, what does that mean to you to just have such an impact so quickly in college?
It's just truly a blessing to be able to even be in a position to be able to do so. Give a lot of credit to my whole line, a lot of credit to my coaches and my teammates for pushing me throughout the season and be able to get this accomplishment.
Over here, James, what has the last month or so been for you, and how have you been able to focus on improving and having that kind of performance today?
This last month, it's been a great month, to be honest, man. Even though we've been through a lot, we still been able to come together and play as a team and just react as a team, be with each other, man. We all stuck together and did what we had to do to become bowl eligible. And now we've been won this bowl game. Now I just want to thank everybody that was put around me, from the coaches to the players, because everybody had great energy and helped me lift up this team and help us be in this position.
James, just how important were those bowl practices for you to go back and look at what you've done this season and maybe learn from it going forward?
It was really important because you get to see your mistakes and see where you made the simple mistakes. You don't want to make the same mistake over and over, so it just gives you a little bit more time to be able to fish your mistakes and work on your craft.
Cam, Cam, can you talk about breaking your record, especially so close to home?
To be able to do it in front of a lot of my family, a lot of the people I went to school with, the home crowd, I loved it. What better time to do it than now? Like I said, all I have to do is thank God for the opportunity.
Cam, I was hoping you could talk about your relationship with Jack Quez. How has he served as a mentor for you, and what's the dynamic with you guys in the running backs room this year?
That's my big brother. He kind of showed me the ropes through everything. You know, every practice I look at what he do. I try to watch the way he watch film. I look up to him as a big brother. More than football, he's a big brother to me. And, I love him as my brother. Yeah.
James, wanted to ask about the way your season went so far. How do you think you can build on this for next season, and how much do you really want to compete for the starting job going forward?
Building on from this season, man, it's just a great season to learn from, man. And what happens in the future just happens. I don't want to speak on that about the starting job, but it's just a season just so you can learn from your mistakes and get better. It's only to build and help you grow.
Any of the players that want to answer this, I think coming into this game, a lot of us were probably guilty of thinking that FSU's going to Shreveport. You guys might not be excited about coming here. Coach said from the start, we are Florida State University and we'll be ready to play. What makes you guys ready to play? Because we've seen other teams that haven't been ready to play bowl games. Who was the most important part? Because obviously you proved it today.
Just being able to take the adversity in and make it positive. Make it have positive energy in the locker room. So we just came out here fired up, knowing that we want our seniors to go out with a bang. So we just had to come out and play. So we just had everybody ready and focused.
Anybody else want to add something to that?
Yeah. Auden, you had three touchdowns today. Can you just talk a little bit about the bond that you developed with James and how that developed over the season?
As the season went along, you know, we had a great bond. You know, like I say, James, you know, he did a tremendous job this year, you know. You know, he ain't had time to grow as a player, really as a person. You know, he had to just come straight in, you know, especially replacing, you know, one of the best quarterbacks in college. You know, he has that, like, leadership qualities that you don't see from a lot of young guys. You know, him being 18, you know, I remember fall camp one time, he was doing, the coach was asking people's feet. You know, a lot of people were saying stuff, but it's like when James got up there, it's like he felt what he was saying. And, like, whenever he talked, everyone got quiet. So, you know, just being young, having them leadership qualities, you know, is something you don't find, you know,
Nate, just the day you had today, being your last college game to be able to go out there and make some plays and go out with a win in your last days, what did it mean for you?
It meant a lot, you know. All year, I mean, I really hadn't played that much, but just being back out there with those guys, it was just a blessing. You know, I could have, like, a lot of guys could have just, I mean, I could have just, like, laid down and got mad at all the coaches because I wasn't playing, but, you know, I just kept on praying and asking God to give me an opportunity, and, like, when the opportunity came, I was ready for it. I mean, I just want to thank all the coaches, especially Coach Waddell. You know, he stuck with us, and I'm thankful for the opportunity to play today.
Came a lot of guys coming in that intimately like a successor of sorts to Dalvin Cook coming in. What's it been like to manage those expectations just during the first year of college and ultimately see the movie?
I just try to play the best of my ability. I can't worry about anybody else going. I just got goals for myself and goals for the team that we're trying to accomplish, and that's all I can focus on. I really focus on that's how I just play football.
Stanford, could you talk about your freshman season and then also what it meant to you guys to have Charles Kelly stick around and help you guys through the bowl practice?
Like everybody else said, I mean, it was a long, hard season, but we stuck together and we pretty much fought the whole season, trials and tribulations. We knew it wasn't going to be easy from the jump. And then running into more adversity toward the end of the season. And I mean, Coach Kelly sticking around just helped us see his loyalty and helped us see where he was at with us and how much he cared and actually put into us. And again, just wanted to leave us and let us go. So I mean, I love him and I appreciate everything he's done for me.
Coach, what was the most challenging thing as far as being the glue for the players and also for the coaches during this transition?
You know, it's tough for me to answer that question because my natural instincts took over. And I know I keep talking about Florida State blood in me, Mickey Andrews, Bobby Bowden, and my mother growing up, and being around great men. It's tough for me to ask the question. My natural instincts just been developed. And you know what? Another biggest part, too, the love I have for these players as an assistant coach, a father figure. I'm going to do whatever it takes to help these young men to try to achieve their goal. That's what it's about. And my natural instinct just took over when I saw them not hurt anymore.
Coach, sort of piggybacking on that, all you've gone through personally and how you've led this team into this, and you talked about, hey, that streak isn't going to end anytime soon. How important is it to you, now that it's finally out, to know you're going to be part of that for years to come?
That's a blessing, man. And that's why I always preach to the young men. Coming to Florida State is different. I played here 5 years, I coached here 23 years. It showed you, when in need, one of the greatest athletes, greatest players ever, to put on the helmet in college football, in NFL, Deion Sanders spent this Saturday to come here and talk to these young men because he believed God in the goal too. We have a special bond here at Florida State University. We love each other, not like each other.
Couple more questions, guys.
Coach, the guys talked about the adversity that they overcome, but to see them from a coaching perspective overcome everything they do and go out here and get this win and finish the season with a win, looking at it from a coach, just how proud are you of these guys?
I'm extremely proud what these young men did. It's amazing. In my career, when I look back, I can say this. I've coached in four or five national championships, one, two, been numerous bowls. This is probably one of the most special seasons I've ever went through to see these young men grow, and have life lessons. That's what this game should be about. And I know everybody's saying the wins and the losses, the national championship, and going to the league. When it all said and done, the life lessons. Make everything better.
Go ahead.
Auden, it's not often in the bowl press conference when there's three true freshmen up on the stage. What does that say about the talent, the young talent on this team, and then also to that point, have you decided what you're going to do in the future?
Talent ain't got no age on it, you know, that's one thing. Of course, it's always say they're going to play the best player. You know, these boys ain't coming here, you know, thinking, okay, I'm coming here just to learn 1 year, do this. No, they came ready to play, you know. They've seen it a lot from this season and from this game specifically.
Hey, your decision?
What's up?
Your decision?
Coach always tell me to be with my feet out, so they right here. So, you know, I'm going to enjoy this win with my team. You know, we're going to go from now.
All right, Wayne, sorry.
James, you know, what's it like having a big target like on Tate who you just throw it up to and you know he's going to come down with it?
Oh, man, you remind me of my big brother, Kevin Benjamin, man. Auden Tate, man, he's just a great player, great guy. It's not great to be around. So once you know he give me that look, I just know what time it is.
All right, last one.
This is a question for James and Cam. What did you guys first think of when Jimbo left for Texas A&M and moving forward for the rest of your career under Willie Tiger? How excited are you to kind of play for your coach now?
Oh, man. I got so much love for Coach Jimbo, man. I just want to tell him thank you for giving me an opportunity to play at Florida State and play on him. But now, like Auden Tate said, Coach said, give me feed that. So I just want to enjoy this one with my teammates.
Like James said, I appreciate Coach Jimbo Fisher a lot. Came to Mississippi and recruited me hard. He got me to come here and he was straight through the decision. I'm looking forward to attacking him.
All right, thank you guys.